It's just a stress reliever. It just clears your mind. You don't really think about anything else. You know, you're just having a great time, enjoying the outdoors. Everything else seems to fade away, is background. There's been times where I haven't been able to ride for various reasons, and once I start riding again, it reminds me why I ride. To choose one particular aspect of riding, I would choose downhill, but really I enjoy it all, from full-on downhill bike park riding to all mountain type stuff, even jumping on the cruiser riding at the beach. Started biking when I was in my early 20s. Actually, my boss at the time gave me a mountain bike. And it was pretty rudimentary by today's standards, but some guys that I worked with had bikes, and we liked to go out and get on the mountain, and pretty much hooked from the first ride. I do the best I can to actually plan in riding around my work events. I'm very fortunate that I get to ride all over BC, which is a huge playground. I'm an independent sales rep in the paddle sports industry, so what that means is I sell kayaks, stand-up paddle boards, canoes, a lot of on the phone, a lot of internet. In the springtime I do a lot of traveling, going to do demo days a little bit later in the season, taking new products so that they know what they're going to be selling next year. As far as jobs go, it's a pretty cool job. With the traveling that I do, of course, it's all through BC and Alberta, and especially in BC, it's mountain bike mecca, and I take my bikes with me when I travel. I was actually delivering a load of kayaks from Ferndale, Washington to actually Aquabatics in Calgary. The sun had just gone behind the mountains, and I guess because there was snow on the sides of the road, which created dampness on the road, as soon as the sun went behind the hills, it flash froze. The whole van started sliding into the oncoming lane, and the first thing that I thought was, I'm about to hit the, and I was gonna think ditch. And then I saw the headlights, and the next thing I thought was, I'm going to, and then before I could think the word die, I was laying in the middle of the road. I was ejected from my van at the point that I head-on collided with a Suburban. I went to stand up. I realized very quickly what had happened. It felt like both my legs were hit with a sledgehammer. I ended up laying on the ground for quite a period of time. It was probably about 25 minutes or half an hour or so before the paramedics got there. I was conscious through the whole thing. I had to deal with the pain because I was awake, and I felt like I wasn't going into shock. The way I did it actually was, I imagined myself snowboarding, surprisingly not mountain biking, but snowboarding in deep powder, to the point where I felt like I actually kind of took myself away from my body, or my brain away from my body, and focused on that so intensely that I could actually focus myself away from feeling the pain. got to the hospital, thankfully there was a very talented surgeon on staff. When I was talking with him, I said, you know, I realize I'm pretty banged up. You know, if I can't run or whatever, you know, that's fine. But, you know, please let me, you know, put me back together so I can ride my bike. And he said, right now, he's like, we're trying to save your foot. This episode of Balance was brought to you by pinkbike.com and Silver Star Bike Park, my favorite place to ride. Here's another cold day in that old November way. Once again, it's begun. I'm stuck in outer space.